Let's go meet him. Naomi has dedicated half an acre to potatoes, but it's only for the family's consumption. She's not ready for the market yet. Our expert of the day, Duncan Mukona from Syngenta, can maybe convince her to go commercial.
My biggest issue is frost. One day you wake up and all of the potatoes are black.
Duncan,
yes.
Do you see any frost here?
Not really, Tony. The challenge that Naomi is facing is not frost. Frost is a natural calamity. It's come because of the weather. But in this case, his challenge is blight. Potato blight.
So this is blight?
Yes, not this is a disease.
When your crop has blight, the leaves turn black and they cannot grow well. This means the potato tubers will not grow well either.
When it's raining, that's when infestation for blight get in, and you can lose your entire crop out of that. In this case, I can show Naomi the solution that we have from Syngenta. The first product is called Lidomil Gold. It's a fungicide that control blight in potatoes. It's able to penetrate inside the system and protecting the crop from within. So it got the prevention in terms of blight control. We got another product by the name Levas. It's able to control blight that we can see with our naked eyes. Mm. The disease will not find itself into the soil to affect your tubers.
For spraying your crops, you mix 50 grams of Lidomil Gold in 20 liters of water. As for Levas, you put 20 milliliters in 20 liters of water. It is best to apply this preventatively. This way, you avoid getting disease in the first place. Follow the instructions of the package when using the product. You should change between these two products. This prevents your crop from building resistance to either one. You will need to wait 7 days after spraying before harvesting this crop. Only then is it safe to eat. This is called the pre-harvest interval, or PHI. The best time for spraying are early in the morning or late in the evening. And never ever forget to wear your personal protective equipment, PPE, when you're handling chemicals.
In this case, you find there are other challenges that they affect your potatoes. We have diseases like bacterial wilt and fusarium wilt. In this case, these are diseases that have no control per se. There is no product that you'll apply and control purely the disease. Okay. But these are also require farmer's practice, where like in this section, if you had planted potato last season, you'll not return or do another potato. And that's what we are calling crop rotation. Like you cannot do tomatoes here because they belong to the same family. You can do like other leafy vegetable like cabbage, spinach.
Okay, I wanted to ask about the residue of the chemicals. How does it affect the soil? Because most of us farmers, we want to farm for the market, and markets like export market, they won't allow anything that has residue.
The product have no residue effect on the soil because you are controlling the blight on the crop. Two, the product are also registered for export. If your market is the export or local, they are allowed to be used targeting the disease that you are fighting.
Is there not a chemical, or rather a chemical really, that can do one spray? You spray once and then, because this is where most of our money goes into.
The product that we are using, they are cost friendly because you are assured of the protection and you are assured to leap high because your yields are free from disease.
Duncan went on to explain that when you put money into spraying with the right product, your crops are able to fight the pests and disease. As a result, you'll get a better yield and more money.
For me, I feel good that I'll try the product and see how it goes.